a real plan, Jay. If somebody's got a question, bring it. Here we go. This is a 900-gallon aquarium I did at the Newport Aquarium. I had a lot of fun with that. That's my old school 220. And this right here is the tank that started it for me. This tank absolutely, it just changed my game when I was doing planted tanks. I had tried them before. That's an actual photo, like a 07, you know, like when you guys use cameras and everything. So, and this was my first dirted tank. And what I learned, everybody at the pet store, I was like, I'm gonna use dirt and I'm gonna put it in an aquarium. And they all thought I was completely on another planet and like I needed to go away. They were like, what are you doing? You're gonna put dirt in your tank and you're gonna screw it up. And I was like, all right, that's cool. Yeah, all right, whatever. And then like every week I brought them in clippings and was like, here, you want some more plants? I need some credit. Here, you want some more plants? I need some credit. Because I was bringing them ridiculous amounts of Ludwigia, the plants in the top there. And so they came over and they were like, oh wow, they're like every square inch of your tank. And I'm like, yeah. And this is where I learned how to feed plants. And it really changed my game. This is a 125-gallon aquarium. The lighting on this is important. We're gonna talk about lighting. The lighting on this was old school fluorescent crappy bulbs, right? Like what you have like in like an old like basement of a gymnasium, you know, like crappy lights. But they were the right spectrum. I'm gonna talk about that. And I had a lot of them. This has a carpet of dwarf sand, very easy plants. This is jungle valve in the back there, Amazon swords, heavy root feeder. Eat at their roots. I'm gonna talk more about that too. Angelfish. One of these angelfish had the most miserable life ever because there was two breeding pairs on either side and it would just get beat like back and forth across its tank. So, I don't know if you guys ever had angels and how they act, but it wasn't right. So, this is what started it for me. I want to talk about tank sizes. You want to get your tanks, the bigger the tank, the better it is, right? The easier it is to do. The exception of that is when a tank is too deep, then you can't get the light all the way to the bottom of it. What can you afford? I had a 220-gallon aquarium. I was like, hey man, I got something to show you in the back. I'm like, all right, what is it? I'm thinking he's got like a fish or like, you know, some plant or whatever. It's a 220-gallon aquarium. It's 30-inch deep tank. You guys might have seen it in some videos. And like I could barely get to the bottom of it. And what I realized with that 500-dollar 220-gallon aquarium was that I had to light it. And lights were like $300-$400 on top of everything I was doing. So understand that you gotta spend some money on lights and you gotta have, you know, all the other stuff that goes with it with your tank sizes. What do you have room for? How many tanks do you have already? See this tank down on the bottom there? I got three tanks that look pretty solid in my old greenhouse. That other one always looked like crap. So don't let your A tank, you know, don't like get spread too thin with too many tanks. Like, you know, keep your one that's awesome, awesome. Don't spread yourself out and have like a bunch of crappy ones or, you know, I don't know. I like to kind of pull it in sometimes on the multi-tank itis that gets us.
And if you like this type of content, make sure you hit that subscribe button, the notification button, and we'll get you more of it.
Lighting. This is my old greenhouse in my backyard. And this is when I learned real hardcore that lighting mattered. And so I, you know, everything was just all over the place, but it didn't matter because I was using the sun. And like lighting, just anything I could do would grow well. So I went to buy, when this worked, and I kind of grew out of my backyard, and Andrew over here on the camera used to edit videos in my family room, like I realized I needed a bigger greenhouse. And there's a fun story with that. If anybody wants to hear it, I can give you a version of it. I don't know if anybody knows about that. You want to hear that version of it? It's not exactly to do with tanks, but it's a good story, happy ending. Anybody know about that story? Okay, I'll talk about that. So I was like, I'm gonna get a bigger greenhouse. Check out this bad boy. This is a 180-foot greenhouse. Out of town, like, I need that. Guess how many people are selling greenhouses? Not a lot. Guess what the market is for greenhouses? It's none. So when you want to go buy a greenhouse, you can just give them whatever you think is right. So this guy was asking $150,000 for this, and I was like, I'll give you $75,000. And he's like, I'm not interested. I'm like, all right, cool. I waited 6 months, sat on my tail. I'll give you $80,000. It was sold. So I'm gonna get this thing. Has anybody heard this story before? Raise your hand if you know this. Oh, even better. All right, cool. Hey, guy goes $80,000. Some of you have. Guy goes, 80 grand. I'm like, awesome, this is great. And so I'm like, cool. I'm real stoked. I'm inside of it. Like, I'm walking around. 180 feet, folks, is like from here to the other wall, right? This is like, I'm going from a 12 by 24, like the size of this stage, to like, to the other wall. So I'm super jacked, right? And I go, and I got to get what's called a variance. So I got to go in front of the city. And I got to go in front of the city, and the lady in the city was like, you better be careful. You better be ready. So I'm standing in front of this greenhouse one day, and I'm like screwing around in the front, and I walk down, I walk across the street, and I'm like this, and I'm like, hey, my name is Dustin, like I'm gonna buy this this greenhouse across the way from you, and I just wanted to introduce myself. And so I go to the lady across the street, and she goes, I'm like the nicest guy I can ever possibly be, right, because this is gonna be my neighbor. She goes, let me tell you about that greenhouse, I'll be right back. She goes inside of her house, she grabs a book this thick, and she goes, here's what's up with this greenhouse. And I was like, well, that went really well. And so then I'm like tripping. I'm like, all right, so this lady like lives across the street from me. It's not like, hey, you're gonna be my neighbor. She's like, she's pissed. Like, okay. So I have to go in front of the city. I go in front of the city to get a variance. I got a suit and tie wrap cleaner than a bar of soap. I go in there and I'm like, yo, my name is Dustin. I got this whole YouTube thing going. Andrew's second day on the job, by the way. It's a public hearing. He's walking in with me. And I go in there, 11 people show up to this. 11 people show up. I worked on this for a year. I got it for 80 grand, right? 11 people show up for this, and they vote, right? 11 people, like, they talk for 2 hours about why I shouldn't have this. This is not going well, right? Like, I'm like, oh, what happened? They go to vote. They vote in a, my neighbor was on the thing, so he had to excuse himself, so they vote in a 3-3 tie. Tie means I don't get the variance. Tie means I don't get this. But guess what? You think I wanted it after that lady was like throwing the book at me, literally? So, this is me not crying because I didn't get the greenhouse. Yes, it is, I was very upset. This is me crying because your lights suck. But no, I didn't get it. And I bawled like a little girl on camera, and everybody resonated with it, and it was like something that I'm sharing personally, because if anybody's going through some hard stuff, keep freaking going. If you're going through hell, keep going, all right? Because this is me sad talking about it. And this is one happy SOB, because once I didn't get that greenhouse, I got this one. And that's one happy dude right there in the middle. And that is my first of now 1, 2, 3 greenhouses in Kentucky. And if you look closely, there's an ecstatically happy dude in there. And I got it built exactly what I wanted. And it goes back to lighting, okay? The roof of that opens into 10 feet, full suns, really fast, have a lot of good fun in it. But it's all about lighting, 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 okay? Mother Nature, like, you need to have good lights. We have a greenhouse, not a warehouse. We grow plants. This is it now. So that's the first half you saw, the other half. And then we got another half behind. You can barely see there. And we're having a lot of fun. There's the sun coming up. Yeah, I sprinted out of bed to get that shot. I like that one. And it's really cool inside too when you see that, by the way. Like, you walk in, you're like, oh my God. So light matters. We grow plants in basins like this. Then this, and it's all about, but it's really fun to walk in and see that in the morning, that too, but it's all about what would Mother Nature do. So if you're like thinking to yourself, like, I can't grow plants, or I'm having a hard time, you gotta just like take a step back and look at what Mother Nature would do and how it would be going, right? So, you know, you want good lights, and lighting your aquarium, how much light, how deep is your tank, and then what are you trying to grow? So how much light? You want as much light as you can freaking give your plants. I'd rather have you have way more light than not enough and your plants suffer, because think about it, what Mother Nature, you're outside, right? Like, it's all, everything, full spectrum. How deep is your tank? If you got a, anybody got a 90 gallon tank? Anybody got a deep one, 90 gallons, what's up, 90 gallons, yeah. That's tough, that's deep. Something called the inverse squared law. For every measure, this is important for the short tanks as well. For every unit of measure you go down from a light source, you exponentially lose light. Good way of looking at it is, look at the way that PowerPoint slides off of there. See how the light gets wider and hits this? So like in a shallow tank, you're getting way more light at the bottom, but in a deeper tank, it's less and less and less and less and less. So keep that in mind with what you're trying to grow. You might be able to grow a plant like crazy in a 10 gallon tank, but in like a 90 gallon tank, it's a lot deeper, a lot harder to do. What are you trying to grow? You can go drop a fern on your toilet, you can grow anubias anywhere, right? Like, it doesn't matter. You're trying to grow some crazy carpeting. Like, I always give the example of Mother Nature, what Mother Nature do. You guys know dwarf baby tears? Anybody keeping dwarf baby tears? None of you, exactly. It's called Hemianthus cuba. Guess where you gotta imitate? Cuba, right? Like, you gotta have the full equator sun. Like, it's hard, it's not easy to do.